Welcome to Owlet Addictions, and we are here to kind of share a little bit of Christmas cheer with all you guys because Christmas looks a little bit differently for all of us this year. On behalf of all of us over here at Owlet Addictions and the Prevention Youth Team and the Outreach Team and the MOA and everyone else that we have on staff here and the COVID Center, we want to make sure that we wish you guys the best Christmas that we possibly can because we don't get to spend it with you like we normally would. But just because we can't be physically with you doesn't mean that we can't emotionally and mentally support you. So don't forget to connect with us if you're in need. We have all decorated our rooms, most of us. The ones that haven't will be get secretly slapped with a bah humbug. And we will be getting voted on by the board of directors to see which room is the best. And so all we need you guys to do is to enjoy this virtual tour. It will be a little bit cut off just because I need to ensure confidentiality is safe for our clients. So I will be stopping filming right before every room and starting back the filming right before every other room, just to ensure that no information is seen or in case there is any client in the building. As soon as I leave this office, I will have to put my mask back on. So it might be a little bit muffly to hear, but we gotta do what we can best and keep everybody safe. So the first room you're gonna tour is actually my room, and it's the room of self-care. Get ready for it. So just from outside my door, we got our COVID-friendly Santa here. This is the room of self-care. So we'll start over here. Self-care is a gift. That's why I've put these gifts on the wall. When you can take care of yourself, it's important to just acknowledge that doing so always creates a better sense of moving forward towards the direction you want in life. The 12 days of self, not Christmas, care. So we have blessings, I walk in peace, which really just represents you just allowing yourself to be happy with who you are. Courage, friendship, my life is a treasure, treasuring every positive moment and really not focusing on the negatives. Enthusiasm, my beloved family, so recognizing the good and the bad and being able to let go of those. Divinely led, charity, kindness, my true name, being true to yourself in a world of love in a time of crisis. And then we come on over to the self-care tree, which during some of my virtual sessions, I'll get a client to tell me a specific color, and then I'll come and pull one of these cards off the tree and read it to them, just to give them a little bit of a different sense of how to connect with what's important to them. And then here we have peek inside to see the most important thing about Christmas. I wonder what it will be. You. And it starts with you because being able to focus on yourself and work through rough times like this is all we need to be able to push forward to make the changes that we want to make. All right, moving over to the next one. And we are upstairs in the outreach wing. As you can see, this is our former group room. Oh, it looks like they got a fire lit in there right now as well, too. They got the nice office with the windows. Not many of us have those. Santa stops here in 9 days. I hope that's right. So this is the outreach's office. This is Miss Jessica and Faith. They put some time and energy into this. You can see there's snowflakes hanging from the top. A snow-decorated Christmas tree filled with all the gifts they're handing out to clients and care packages. Nicely lit fire. Stenciled snowflakes. Christmas music just for that extra touch. And they snowed their windows with designs. Oh, yes, you finally caught one of them. There's Miss Jessica here.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas from all the outreach staff. Any advice you give them on this Christmas?
Stay safe and stay healthy.
Stay safe and stay healthy. All right, moving to the next room, guys. So we know this office wasn't decorated just because the prevention team is always out and about. So I humbugged them. I think we got Gemma hiding in here as well, too. So let's just go see if we can get them to say a Merry Christmas. Miss Gemma, Mr. David, I found you. would you like to say Merry Christmas?
Merry Christmas.
Any other things you'd like to share with the clients at Owlet Addictions?
Merry Christmas. Stay safe. Positive thinking. Healthy decisions.
Ooh, you sounded prepared for that, but you really were not. Jenna, anything else you want to share, Gemma?
No.
Just leave me alone and let me drink my coffee?
Yes, please.
Okay, Merry Christmas. Jenna's been running away from me, but I just found her at the photocopier machine, so I'm getting her to say Merry Christmas. So Jenna is one of our prevention team members. She works with all the elementary school kids and she's phenomenal. So I was going to catch her no matter what. And if it had to be here, it had to be here. Okay, we're going to be approaching Megan's office here. As you can see, she made a beautiful lit Christmas tree. She is one of our adult counselors, new to the team. Anything you'd like to share with the clients of Alouette Addictions, Miss Megan?
Just Merry Christmas. Have a good holiday season.
Have a good holiday season. Any Christmas advice for the ones that might be at home?
Yourself with lights. It always makes me feel better.
I love it. Surround yourself with lights. All right, moving all over here to the Bah Humbug. So Miss Heather's in session right now on the phone, so we won't bother her. But we'll come on over to Steve's office. Mr. Steve, Bah Humbug. Would you like to explain what's going on?
No clients in the office, no decorating.
Oh, he's putting on a strike for you guys. He must miss our clients. All right, well then. Hold on.
Oh, beautiful.
Okay.
Yeah, Bah Humbug.
Absolutely.
Add it to your door. This wing of the office probably will not be decorated just because it's the MOA office and they're always out and about and super busy. Let's see if we can catch Miss Sue and Miss Cheryl over here. Oh, he's working away. But you're still getting slapped with the Bah Humbug. Would you like to say anything to the clients at Alouette?
Merry Christmas, have a safe holiday, and a happy new year.
Perfect. And I know Michelle's in here because I saw her a second ago. Miss Cheryl, anything you want to share with the clients?
Merry Christmas! Happy New Year!
What about the service providers? Any different message?
Everybody be safe and thanks for everything.
And she, well, does she have anything Christmas in there? No.
Bah Humbug!
Oh, and Miss Dorothy, our new clinical supervisor. Anything you'd like to share with Alouette Addiction Services clients and service providers?
Well, just want to wish you all the best during the season and to look after yourselves and each other and to be gentle. It's a difficult time of year at the best of times, and it's especially important to reach out if you're needing anything. We're here for you.
Perfect. Couldn't have said it better, and that was not scripted. As you can see, there's nothing in her hand, but she is getting Bah Humbug.
All right.
Down the hall to the outreach and then Miss Laura outreach supervisor office. You can see here Miss Sandra. She's always working away. She's got her reindeer and her little Christmas thing on there. She's got everything decorated. Laurel's running away from me. You can see her in the background there with her white hat. She's trying to not get caught on camera, but we're going to invade her space next. So we're going to go on over here into the winter wonderland. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. And she was not kidding. So Miss Laurel put in all this extra time on her breaks. And you can see it's beautifully done. She's got her fire lit, music playing. And you're not in here to experience it, but she really outdone us. And she put on like a scent, a Christmas scent. So I don't know if I should even explore any other offices, but I will definitely do so. Be naughty, save Santa, save the trip. And you can see here she got prepared for a little snowball fight. So beautiful. So Miss Laurel is our outreach supervisor. And I will also be going over to the COVID center later just to check out the COVID center for you. So here it is, the winter wonderland.
And Laurel's worn clothes specially for the event.
You hear Steve giving trouble in the background?
Look, she's got snowball pants on.
She even wore her snowball pants. Look at her go. She wins. Here we go. I vote for her too. All right, we're going on. So on our last offices up here, as you can see, the HR is getting slapped with the Bah Humbug. But the good news is she's too busy to decorate. So that's probably a good sign. And then we got our executive director over here, Doug. And I'm going to come in and bombard him because he's got the dark Christmas. Now, can you tell me a little bit about this room?
Okay, so I think that it's important you notice that I have a dying poinsettia on my table. And the poinsettia, I think it's very fitting that the poinsettia, which is poisonous to children and to adults, that the plant that we associate with Christmas is in fact poisonous. And you can see that I have my phony ficus tree that is decorated with everything black. And then someone came into my office and put the Grinch, which I think is wonderful. And then you see a sort of a, really a statue to me.
No, no,
what,
no.
What is Christmas about other than me? So mine says no, no to ho, ho. And which kind of sums up the way I feel about Christmas. So happy holidays to everyone. I hope you have a way better Christmas than I'm going to have. And here's all the best for a COVID-free 2021. And I know that everybody will be glad to say goodbye to 2020. I know we will here.
Agreed. Love it. She's back! Karen, anything you want to say to anybody out there on Christmas time?
Merry Christmas!
I busted her. I got Jenna too like that. So I've just walked into the ISO unit. For those of you that don't know what the ISO unit is the ISO unit is the place where homeless people can come and quarantine after being tested for COVID. So it's a safe space for them to be out of the community and have a place to be by themselves safely in quarantine awaiting their results. If they are positive, they will be isolated. Well, they will stay isolated in their own room. And again, they will be able to stay here until their results are coming back negative. Just a little bit of the ISO. None of the workers are in here right now. This is not a room that one of the clients would reside in. This is just a space where the workers would work out of to make sure the intake goes okay. But I am the one that gets to describe it. For more details, please ask Miss Laurel Hickman, because I'm sure she knows a heck of a lot more than me. Normally I could find Brittany in here, but she's not here right now, so I'll track her down somewhere else, hopefully. When the supervisors leave the office, we sneak around to play. Whee! Hopefully I'm not breaking any of these. Don't tell Laurel. Well, that brings our tour to a close. With that being said, we'll kind of give you a recap of what offices are up to being judged. So the Office of Self-Care by Caitlin Ross, Prevention Worker, myself. We have the Outreach Office upstairs, which is Jessica and Faith, which was the one with the snowflakes painted on the window and the two fireplaces. We also have the Bah Humbug Executive Director Office, Black Christmas, which is the one with the no-no to ho-ho. We downstairs, we have the Winter Wonderland, which is Laurel Hickman's office, which is our outreach supervisor. Across the hall from her, we had our outreach extra office, which all of our support extra outreach workers work out of. And there we saw Sandra. And then down the hall, we have the Bah Humbug Steve's office, who is on strike because he will not decorate because no clients can come in. And then down the hall, we have Megan with the Christmas tree on the wall office, lights make her happy. And just around the corner from that, we had a couple of Bah Humbugs, Miss Dorothy, Miss Cheryl, Miss Sue. And then I wasn't able to catch Miss Emily on video, but I promise I'll get her next year. So those are the offices up for judging. We also have the ISO unit, which is added in at the end there. And that's just the one room of the ISO unit, just where the workers work out of. So happy judging. And again, on behalf of all Alouette Addictions, I think the theme of today was to stay healthy and happy. Sometimes happy doesn't always look the same way. So working through this the best you can and being supported by the ones around you. Make sure you have some type of support network in place and you have someone to connect to if in need. And remember, we are here. We are closed for a couple of days over the holidays, but we do have options to connect with that are 24 hours if needed, not through Alouette, but we do have resources. So feel free to connect if you're in need. And please try to do your best to stay happy and healthy, because we are really looking forward to a brand new year with all of you. Happy holidays from Alouette Addictions.